from Friday evening when this office was put into mode. But yeah, everything was working quite well Saturday evening. And the only thing I was a bit disappointed was on Sunday. I really wanted to put in some good stage times, and initially we done that with a good stage, the first one out on Sunday morning. But after that, it was just problem after problem, and it turned into just a survival.
Well, survival and finishing fourth isn't bad at all. I mean, look at some of the people you beat.
Yeah, for sure. I think I know a lot of people fell into trouble as well. Maybe not, maybe a bit more trouble than we had. But we just tried to keep our noses clean, especially when things didn't happen with my own car. We just needed to keep out of trouble. And you know, thank God with Pirelli tyres, we didn't have one puncture, which I think was a big thing in a rally like that. Which you know kind of gave us a good buffer going into Sunday. But yeah, fourth overall, I'm absolutely chuffed to bits. It's better than what I've done in Zinn, which is what I set out to do really. And you know, a long way to continue.
Do you plan next year to do some more, a lot more IRC events?
I suppose it's purely down to how the academy pans out in GB. If we win the academy, which I hope we do, that €500,000 is going to have to be spent back in the World Championship. So if that's the case, then it'll be SWRC for sure. God forbid we don't win the academy. Well then, yeah, we need to leave every option open really. And for sure, the two IRC events that I've done so far this year have been excellent. You know, I could be biased because they went very well for me, but I think they were very well organised. I like the scene, I like the people, the competition is very good. So, you know, why not consider it?
Well, you've got that final WRC Academy round, of course, at Wales Rally GB next month. But before then, you're stepping up to SWRC. It's very complicated. You're following you around, Craig. Which car are you in next? Sometimes I dare say you wonder which car you've got to go to in Parc Fermé. But you've got this coming up in Spain, and you're presumably looking forward to that very much indeed.
Yeah, I done the event in 2009 in the R2 car. Obviously, that was just sealed surface then. I haven't been on these mixed surface stages yet. So, yeah, it's going to be, again, a new challenge, mixed surface events. The pace in the SWRC has been really hot this year with Oit and Yuho. So it's going to be nice to see, you know, where I can gauge my pace against these guys. You know, I don't expect to go there and blow people away. I just want to see whereabouts I am in the bigger picture. You know, these guys have been doing the championship all year long. Okay, I might know the rally from 2 years ago, but again, these gravel stages are all coming new to me. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. It's a beautiful rally, especially the tarmac. It's real racetrack stuff, which I quite like going from karting. So I'm looking forward to it.
Of course, this business is just as much about business as it is about results. You've got to find the money. The results help you bring the money, and so on and so forth. The Irish economy has been just about as parlous as anywhere else in Europe over the last couple of years. Is it hard to raise the cash you need to get the machinery you want for the events you've got to do?
Yeah, it's extremely difficult. You know, as you said, in these times. And unfortunately, in Ireland, I think rallying couldn't possibly be any lower in the tier of popularity. Really, it's just
so many people doing it, and so many people seem to have cars.
Yeah, I know, but within the Irish media, you know, like for instance, if I go back to Rally Scotland last weekend, I didn't receive much. I didn't receive any TV coverage or nothing. And when we asked Justice Beaver for it. For an explanation, they compared to an IRC as playing a friendly match in a regional county. You know, it just doesn't register. So yeah, it's extremely difficult, and especially when I am doing a lot of rallying, you know, people put me into a category and just say, oh, well, you know, that boy can afford to do it. There's no need to support them, which is extremely difficult because if they knew what had to be done to get me to these rallies, I think they would look at it in a different light.
I suppose the problem is that it is an equipment sport. I mean, if you were an athlete or a football player, you don't have to pay to play. You don't have to invest quite so much in the machinery just to do those sports. Motorsport's expensive.
Yeah, it's horrific. Ever since I've been racing cars since I was 8 years of age, and even after, you know, maybe 2 or 3 years of that, the cost just completely spiraled, and then into rallying. Especially in the super developing car and doing events like Scotland the weekend, you know, quite rough on the car. And you know, we only had like a 3 day turnaround before the car leaves for Spain today. So it's a massive amount of work that's involved in running one of these cars, and logistics and, you know, hotels and just everything keeps on adding up. And no matter at the start and you can always put maybe 10 or 15% on everything, but it always ends up exceeding that. So to get a sponsor to try that, it's extremely difficult.
Well, if nothing else, the results are coming, and if you can actually manage to win the WRC Academy at the end of the year, then if you're not going to be quits in, you're certainly going to be better off than you were at the start. And you must look forward to that. You've just got to keep delivering as you did in Scotland last weekend.
Yeah, it needed to be done because, you know, before that, I was still a youngster that had only won a couple of cup car trophies in the Fiesta, so I wasn't really backing myself up, and I need to be realistic. Okay, 7th in Flynn and 4th in Scotland, that's still people that will beat me in the IRC, so I'm not shining. You know, Andreas Mikkelsen is the man that's shining at the moment, so I need to be realistic and keep the feet on the ground. What I'm doing at the moment is what's required. It's not excelling, so we just need to concentrate on doing the best we can between now and the end of the year and see what's available.